Real news. Real stories. She's breaking it down for you. Investigating step by step. Leaving no stone unturned. She gets to the bottom of it so that you can know the truth. This is Storytime with Aaliyah Renee, and I'm your host, Aaliyah Renee.
Hi, welcome to Storytime with Aaliyah Renee, and I am your host, Aaliyah Renee. Today, we're going to dive deep into the story of a woman who was stood up, y'all. That's right, I said it. Can you believe it? I cannot believe it. She was stood up for a date. What a story. Tragic, I tell you. Tragic. Really. We even have actual actor portrayal. And even pictures. Actual pictures of the victim from the night that she was stood up. You're going to see it all, ladies and gentlemen. You're going to see it all. I got the case. The case is right here. So grab your wine, grab your tea, grab your popcorn, grab your favorite treat to snack on. Come on, I'm taking you on the journey to the day she was stood up on Storytime with Aaliyah Renee. And I'm your host, Aaliyah Renee.
Alicia Carey was born January 8, 1996. She was a great student with great friends who loved to have fun. Her life was going great until she graduated and was stood up.
Joining us now is two of Alicia Carey's closest friends, Tia Saint and Asia Smith. Please tell me what it's like knowing Alicia and how has this relationship with Karell Johnson affected her?
I've known Alicia for a while now. She's always happy, always energetic. She's about her coin, and she's very focused. So when I heard about her giving Karell another chance, I was like, oh no, baby, he's no good. She can do way better.
Alicia and I are best friends, more like sisters. And I knew something was going on with her. So I was like, what's up, sis? What's going on? She was like, I was stood up. I was like, stop, sis. She was like, deadass. I was like, you deadass, deadass. I was like, how? You a whole entree? Well, this is a loss. Then I was like, wait. So who stood you up? And when she said Karell, I was like, oh, hell no, him? You need to level all the way up.
Well, thank you two ladies for joining us via satellite. Now, we're going to head over to our exclusive interview room where Alicia Carey herself is in there waiting for us right now. Right now as we speak, she's in there. So let's go over and see what she has to say.
Right after this commercial from our sponsors.
On Storytime with Aaliyah Renee, and I'm your host, Aaliyah Renee. For just 25 cents a day, you can help rescue dogs like Chihuahua. They need your help. The money you will be donating will go directly to our rescue team to help more animals like Chihuahua. Please, donate from your heart. You can help save lives, and after all, we're all God's children, aren't we? So please, call the number on the right of your screen today.
I need some distraction. Joining us now is Alicia Carey. She opted for her identity to be hidden. Welcome to the show, Alicia. How are you?
I'm doing good. I'm doing really good.
Thank you so much for being here. Please, share with us your story.
So, yeah, I was a victim of being stood up, you know. I thought for once, you know, he'll come through for me, you know. And it was like any other day, you know. And that just happened.
So how did you two meet?
Well, I met Karell Johnson actually when we were both at high school. I was in the 11th grade, I believe, and he was in the 10th. And you know, back then I was like a little cheerleader or whatever. And I was cheerleading. And I know he was at like the first game. I remember it like it was yesterday. And that's the first time I actually looked at him like, okay, like, look at you, okay. You know, that was the first time I actually looked at him like that, because I was told already that he had a little crush on me, but, you know, I was like, I don't know, like, he's a 10th grader, and I really don't have time for boys. I'm trying to focus on my schoolwork. But then that day, at the cheerleader, at the basketball game that day, I was like, okay, you feel me? So I was like, okay, and yeah, from there, it just developed, and we had a little thing going, I guess you can say. I guess you can call it boyfriend, girlfriend, but I really don't count this as like a real relationship. But at the time, I counted it as something real because I did actually like him. And yeah, and then we got to fast forward. Like I said, that was when I was in 11th grade. You know, we only was like together, I guess you can say, quote unquote, together for like a month and whatever like that. And then fast forward to after I graduated high school and, you know, I'm done with high school. And then it happened, you know. He hit me up one random day when I was at work. You know, I was at work. I was minding my business, just chilling in the break room, whatever. And then, like, he calls me. And I'm just like, hello? And he's like, hey. He's just like, oh, like, you're always busy. You never make time for me. And I'm so confused because it's like, where is all of this coming from? Like, where is all of this coming from? Like, how can you say I never make time for you when it was clear that I liked you a lot, you know, back in the day? But he was just claiming that I never made time for him. He was the one who always made time for me. And he was trying to take me out. So I'm just like, well, in my head, I didn't say this out loud, but I was like, shit, I can eat, you know, like, let's be real, I can eat, and you know, like, he cute or whatever, so I'm just like, you know, he cute, and I can eat, so I'm just like, shit, let's see, and you know, I usually don't get excited about things, because, you know, things can change, and also, I was just focused on work, focused on going to school, at the moment, so it's just like, I really wasn't thinking about no other guy. I was just thinking about, like, yo, get your money, stack your money, get what you want to get, be independent. Like, that's all I was concerned about. But, you know, like, I was like, okay, I'm going on a little date or whatever, you know, living my little best life. I'm 18 or whatever. So I'm just like, yes, girl, do you. So then the day came. It was November 11th, 2013. Remember that like it was yesterday, because it was 11 12 13, you feel me? And yeah, I was getting all excited, you know, putting my rods in my hair. You know how it is, you put your little rods up in your hair to get it all curly, whatever, the no heat method. And I did my little makeup, whatever, and I just felt fresh. Like, I felt like, yo, I'm about to go on this date. We about to have fun, we about to eat, we about to catch up on old times, or just catch up on life in general, and just have like a cool, chill date, you know? And then I was waiting, I was sitting on my couch, and my mom, she was in the back, and she's just like, that you was going out, what time are you going out? Because it's like 9 o'clock, and you know, I'm still 18, so like, my mom, hello, get your ass back in the house, you know, type shit, you know? Oh, can I say that? Can I curse? I can curse, yeah?
I tried to refrain from cursing.
All right, so yeah, I was like, yeah, you know, my mom, like, she wants to protect me. She want to make sure I'm good. So I'm just like, mom, chill, like, chill, bro. Like, chill out, my guy. Like, stay calm, stay easy, bro. Like, chill, bro, like, chill. And she's like, nah, but like, for real, real, like, why don't you just stay in? We can just order food, watch movies. I'm like, in my mind, I'm like, girl, I'm trying to give him my hands. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, oh, you know, mom, we can do that like another night. She's just like, it'll be fun. I'm just like, no, this one is being, oh, you know what I'm saying? But then, so I'm waiting, 9 o'clock turns into 9:30. So I'm like, let me call him. Let me see what's good, right? So I calls him and he's like, oh nah, like I'm getting ready, I'm almost done, I'm gonna send a cab your way. And I'm just like, oh, you about to send the cab my way, you feel me? So I'm hype and shit, like, okay, okay, you about to call the cab, you gonna, I'm like, all right, alrighty, ready, ready. So I'm waiting, 9:30 turns into 10 o'clock, I'm like, oh, baby. You know, that's what I'm thinking, like, oh, baby, like, it's 10 o'clock, like, oh, my stomach is growling at this point, like, I'm hungry, like, hungry, hungry, you hear me? So I'm just like, what time we out? Because like it's 10 o'clock now and this cab's been coming for like 30 minutes at this point. So I'm just confused as to when I'm finna leave. You feel me? And my mom is in the back like, yo, what's good? What is good? It's 10 o'clock now. What time you think you want to be getting out there and then to be making it back? It's getting light. And I'm like, yo, chill. But I'm like, deadass, mom's is tight right though. Like, she right at the end of the day. Like. So then I spoke to him and he was just like, yeah, we ain't going out. And I was like, and he was like, nah, it ain't even like that, man, it ain't even like that. And I'm like, so what it's like, Corral? And he like, something came up. I'm like, what came up, Corral? And he like, chill, bruh, chill. I'm like, don't tell me to chill. What is good? Because I've been waiting here on this couch. And I'm hungry. What's going on? And then, like, he texts me what was going on. And I'm like, oh, my God, no. Oh, my goodness. Is this true? And he like, yeah. And at the time, I was dumb. I'm not gonna lie. I was really naive. I was really dumb. Because looking back at it, that excuse was a bunch of bullshit. It was bullshit. He was totally standing me up. But, you know, at the time, I'm like, oh, my God. I'm sending my prayers out to you and everyone. Like, I hope. Lord, I'm gonna pray. So then I had to play it off, you know, because, like, I can't let my mom know I was, you know, stood up and shit. So, oop, my bad. I couldn't let my mom know I was stood up and stuff. So, I was just like, you know what, mom? You know what today's the perfect day for? She was like, day is night, baby. I'm like, you know what today's the perfect night for? She's like, what? I was like, ordering some Chinese food and watching a movie. She's like, didn't I just say that? I was like, you know. I was sitting on that couch and I was thinking. I had to think to myself, like, do I really, really want to go out today? And I was like, no. You know, my mom is here. My mom is cool. You know, she's cool as well. Okay, she cool. And Chinese food, you know, it or whatever, it's good. And I was just like, yeah, like, we should totally watch a movie and eat Chinese food because this is really what I wanted to do today. Well, tonight. And yeah, that's how that happened.
Is this picture of you after you were stood up?
Yeah, that is my face. Yeah, that's how it was, you know, after he stood me up. That was the face I made. And I know you're probably wondering if I could show my face back then, why not show it now? It's because, honestly, I've grown into my own person. I've grown into my own woman. And I don't want to be associated with that girl, with that 18-year-old self. Like, I'm a whole new woman now. You know, I grew up. You know, that picture, it looked bad. But, like, I glued up. I grew up all the way. And I don't want to be associated with her. You know, I'm a homegrown woman now.
So have you talked to Corral since you were stood up?
Yes, I did hear from Corral after that incident. Like I said, that was November 12, 2013. And I did hear from him after and stuff like that. He suggested we do, like, you know, a Christmas exchange of gifts or whatever. And my dumb butt back then, I actually bought him a gift after he stood me up and showed me his true colors. And I still bought the gift, and I still gave him the gift, and I did not even receive a card, which is what I wanted.
Thank you so much, Alicia, for sharing your story. Now we'll be sitting down with Karell Johnson, the man in the center of the story. Welcome, Karell.
So,
may you please share with our viewers why you stood Alicia Carey up back in the day?
Man, I don't even know why I'm here, man.
Oh, you're
here
to share with our viewers why you stood up Alicia Carey back in the day.
I don't know why I'm here.
Really? You don't know why you're here? So are you saying you never stood up Alicia Carey?
Stood up? This is what I'm talking about. Nah. I'm not here for all that.
So, Karell, what are you here for then?
What you mean what I'm here for then?
What did you come to tell our viewers today?
Alright, boom, I'll tell you what I'm here for. I'm just here to collect a check. I'm about my paper, man.
I beg your pardon? I thought you were here to tell us about you standing up Alicia Carey, but you seem to have no knowledge of that.
You know what? Fuck this shit. I'm out.
Well, that has been very interesting, ladies and gentlemen. I really did try my best to do this interview with Karell, but he decided that this interview was not in his best interest.
This has been a very interesting case. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope you tune in next time for Storytime with Aaliyah Renee. And I am your host, Aaliyah Renee. Thank you and good night.